Hi, everyone, and welcome to Huddle in Place with the Nine-Sided Circle. We are up to episode 44, and it is May 11th, 2020. And I'm one of your hosts. I'm Noor Kyle, and I'm in Los Angeles for the time being. And what about you, my other host?
I am the other host. I am Mushtaq Ali. I am somewhere in the night skies of the Bay Area.
Pretty. So that's what that is.
Yeah, that's a night sky.
Awesome. Yeah,
I guess it could be. Or I have a lot of lint on my lens.
Your background's being a little weird.
That's because the light is very, very low and it's trying to get through the window where my green screen is.
Still pretty, though.
Yeah, it screws it up every now and again.
Oh, that's fine. No worries. It looks like it belongs there almost. Space being weird.
Just more stars. I can make it even weirder by leaning.
All right. So anything going on that we need to update folks about?
The world is getting stranger by the day. The settlers in, or I should say colonials in South Dakota are looking to stir up trouble with the Sioux again.
The colonizers.
Yep.
Yep. Yeah. The, indigenous nations have been trying to protect their borders because their community is so vulnerable, and they have the legal right, as far as I understand, to be able to do that. But the state, on the other hand, is not happy about that.
No, and legal rights have never really mattered when it came to government native relations.
Yep.
It's all about the people. So in South Dakota, they're all butthurt because the Sioux want to not even keep people out, but just go through some basic checks and make sure that they aren't bringing shit in. Whereas in New Mexico, especially along the Rio Grande Pueblos, they're not getting any hassle from the governor. And they're all being very, very careful and closing their roads off and, you know, closing the reservations off from outside tourists and stuff.
Well, it's both sad and, you know, that contrast really sucks. It's really too bad that we can't all be on the same page. And I mean, I'm glad that New Mexico is taking that tack, because that's what we need to do. And South Dakota is just gonna, it's gonna be a mess.
Yeah. The relationship between the Dakotas and the native people have never been good. So that's what we have come to expect.
So there's that.
There's that.
Yeah. And, you know, there's also the fact that in California, we are expecting things to be worse than recently projected because of the fact that we plateaued. But that doesn't mean numbers are dropping off in terms of new infections and deaths and things like that.
In the moment we plateaued, we did stupid shit.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. Like we talked about in our last Huddle in Place video, people are taking this, you know, this shift in opening businesses and stuff as a sign that things are better. And as one of our health administrators for the city of LA has said, nothing has changed about this virus. It is exactly the same virus that got us in lockdown in the first place, in terms of how it affects people, how it makes people suffer. And people are going to experience a shock when they realize that opening businesses is not going to make an instant rebound economically.
Nope. And if they are not careful, they get sick, they bring it home, and grandma or the kids die.
And also, speaking economically, people are going to lose confidence that things are going well, because they're going to realize that this reopening is not what they expected it to be, and we're going to have an even slower recovery as a result. are all big things to talk about, but what
we really
wanted to delve into today, is, you know, human impulses in moving either away from things that we find unpleasant or moving towards things that give us comfort and nurturing and all that stuff. These are both very strong, hardwired tendencies. And I'd love it if Mushnak would say a little bit more about that.
All right. This is something that goes back to the, even before humans were humans, but for humans especially. Here we are. We see this beautiful, luscious grove of fruit. You know, maybe vines of grapes hanging down, and we would start moving towards it, thinking about all of the delicious taste and the sweetness and the wetness of the grapes. And then we hear a mountain lion snarl. And we're running away from that those grapes as fast as we can. We are hardwired to put way more attention and energy into moving away from what we don't want than moving towards what we do want. And this is important because it has kept us from getting killed for a very, very long time.
Mm-hmm. It's a powerful survival mechanism.
Yes. And it can have problems, especially in the modern world and in the world of things that are not going to eat you.
Mm-hmm.
You will notice how often you say, "What do you want?" And the answer that you get is, "I don't want that. I got this thing in my life and I don't want it. I want to change it."
Yeah, or even, "I want to not blah, blah, blah."
Yeah, "I want to not be in lockdown." That's a good one. Mm-hmm. "I don't want to be stuck in this house anymore." Mm-hmm. The trouble is that now back in the day, predators figured this behavior out. And so here you are one of your ape-like ancestors and you're foraging for something yummy. And all of a sudden this lion pops up and he goes, "Hi." And you go, "Oh shit, a lion." And you run away. You turn around and you run exactly away from that lion, not realizing that that lion's buddy snuck around and is hiding in the bushes in the exact direction that you're running right now.
Mm-hmm.
And then you leap out and you're dinner. So
you can see this in action on pretty much any Discovery Channel documentary about predators and herd animals. So
The predator you see is not necessarily the one that you need to worry about.
Mm-hmm.
But be that as it may, we do have this tendency to move away from what we don't want. What we need to do is ask ourselves what we do want. In the case of our ancestor, what they wanted was to go to a place of safety. They wanted to get back to the cave where all of their buddies were, who had rocks and sticks and all of that kind of stuff and could leap out and throw shit at the lion.
Mm-hmm.
And since we're primates, I mean that literally.
The good old days, right?
The good old days.
So as we were discussing, you know, in our prep, you were saying that when we strategize moving away from, I mean, it's not even strategizing. It's really like a reactive, impulsive response.
Yeah.
When we are led by that, we end up at a random destination rather than an intended destination per se.
Yeah, you get stampeded by what you don't want.
Mm-hmm.
And that's no fun. So my suggestion, and this is only a suggestion, so you don't really have to follow it unless you want to, is that when you hear yourself saying to yourself, "I don't want this thing," that you ask yourself, "What do I want instead?" And when you come up with that, when you come up with a positive goal, it's like, "I don't want to be in the house." what do you want instead? I want to go to the beach. Mm-hmm. Okay. Then you can go, how can I safely go to the beach so that I don't bring the plague back home with me?
Yeah.
Or so that I don't give the plague to anybody else, which is even more obnoxious than getting it yourself. Mm-hmm. Just saying.
Yeah, and there's something to be said about taking note of your reactions. When you hear yourself in your own head, or if you see yourself in your behavior recoiling in such a way that it is speaking to you, I don't want this. Like I said, that's useful information. Take note of that, respect that, and then figure out a way to rephrase that in a way that you can take action on. Just like Mishtaq is talking about.
Yeah, when you can go, I want this instead, then you know which direction to run in. Mm-hmm. And you know how to look for the dangers, because there's always dangers.
Yep.
Don't let that fool you. There is always dangers.
Definitely. I mean, the virus, I guess we could say, is the lion just sitting in
the virus there. Is, in fact, a predator. It is looking to prey upon us. Mm-hmm. And we don't have to let it.
Yeah, and play your cards right, and you actually will be less frustrated because you're able to find a way to move toward a thing that makes you happy as opposed to moving away or fixating on something that's frustrating or upsetting you. So
that's our advice for the day, such as it is. Mm-hmm. Ask yourself, what do I want instead of this thing that I don't want?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And act in such a way that you can safely and happily get it without creating more problems for yourself.
That's the goal.
Yep.
Yeah. Awesome. So we will be taking our own advice.
Yes. Mm-hmm. You know what I want?
What do you want?
Dinner.
Dinner. Ooh.
Dinner. Yes.
I want to watch Netflix.
Dinner and Netflix. What a good idea.
Yeah.
Cool. All right, folks. Thanks for hanging out with us, and we will see you tomorrow.
Yep. Take care.